Now that we have seen that some dependencies can become hazards in our pipeline, now we need to see how to handle these hazards so that we still get correct execution in our pipeline. Because we cannot just allow the pipeline to produce incorrect results. We need to handle only the situations that are hazards. We don't really care about dependencies that can never become hazards. In fact, what we need to do is detect hazard situations and then either flush dependent instructions from the pipeline, stall dependent instructions in the pipeline so that the read is delayed and they get the correct value, or even fix values that were read already by the dependent instructions so that we feed them the right value and they proceed unharmed through the pipeline. We need to use flushes for control dependencies because the instructions we have in the pipeline after a control dependence becomes a hazard are the wrong instructions. So delaying them or trying to fix the values that they are reading is not going to work. Pretty much we have to delete these instructions from the pipeline and fetch the correct ones and then execute them from scratch. So we need to flush the dependent instructions on a control dependence. If we have a data dependence, we can stall the subtract so that it stays in the stage where it would read R1 until finally the add deposits that value in the register. So for hazards caused by data dependencies, we do not have to flush, we can simply stall. For some data dependencies, we can even forward the value of R1 produced by the add to the subtract in a way that fixes the value read by the subtract. Let's consider our 5-stage pipeline and just worry about the stage where we read the registers and the ALU stage. In a cycle where the subtract is reading the registers, the add is in the ALU stage. At the end of this cycle, the subtract has read the wrong register value for R1 because R1 still doesn't have what add will eventually write to it. But the add at the end of this cycle has the value, it's just that it didn't put it in R1 yet. What we now can do is at the beginning of the following cycle, subtract can get the value that the add produced, and that value replaces the value that we read from R1, so that subtract computes with the correct value. So pretty much, if the value exists somewhere in the pipeline, at the point before we actually use the value to compute, we can fix what we have read so that we still compute with the right value. This is called forwarding, and it amounts to pretty much fixing the values read by dependent instructions. Forwarding does not always work. Sometimes the value we need will be produced at a later point in time, so at the time we need it to compute, we still don't even have that value in the pipeline. At that time, we need to stall instead of forwarding. So basically, for control hazards, we need to flush. For some data hazards, we can either stall or forward, and we prefer forwarding because it doesn't introduce stalls in the pipeline. And for some data hazards, at least some stalls are necessary.